Hi dear students, in this video I am going to talk about hybridization, introduction of hybridization and SP, SP2, SP3 hybridizations. All these topics are from the chapter Chemical Bonding and Molecular Structure. Hybridization. Dear students, hybridization is a hypothetical concept, theoretical concept, which is useful in explaining the shape of the molecules and some of the properties of molecules. Hybridization is hypothetical concept or the theoretical concept. It came from the CH4 molecule, methane. Carbon atomic number 6, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p2 is a electronic configuration. Ground state configuration, we can write it as 2s as 2 electrons, 2p subshell as 3 orbitals, in which only 2 orbitals are having one electron each. First excited state of carbon, this electron present in the 2s orbital, it will jump into the 2p orbital. Then it has a four unpaired electrons are present in the carbon for the first excited state. 2s, this is a 2p subshells. Then in the CH4, hydrogen atomic number 1, electronic configuration 1s1, right? Hydrogen will try to achieve duplet, 2 electrons in the outermost shell. So students, according to VBT valence bond theory, types of overlappings in CH4 is, so here single electron is present in 2s orbital of carbon, it is overlapping with the 1s orbital of 1 hydrogen. So 2s, 1s, 1, right? And 2p, 1s, if it is 2px, 2PY 1s, 2PZ 1s. All these 1s, 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 1s indicates hydrogen atoms. There is a 2 different overlappings are there. 3 overlappings, that is a 2P 1s, 2P 1s, 2P 1s. This is different from the 2S 1s overlapping. Then actually, because of difference in the overlapping, the 4 bonds which are present in the CH4 molecule, 3 should be one type, other should be the other type. 3 should be of the same type, the other 4th bond should be different. Because according to VBD, a chemical bond forms due to overlapping of atomic orbitals. But experimentally it is proved that all the bonds are equal. To explain that, chemists has been developed the new concept which is known as hybridization. Students, now let us discuss about the conditions for hybridization. Dear students, there is some conditions for the hybridization. What type of orbitals will undergo hybridization to form hybrid orbitals? First condition is atomic orbitals present in valence shell of autumn will be hybridized. Autumn will be hybridized. Students, in a particular autumn, the orbitals, atomic orbitals present in the outermost shell, they will be hybridized. Atomic orbitals with small difference, with a small difference in energies will get hybridized. Students, that means if some orbital, if it is like a 4s orbital, that is s orbital present in the fourth orbit, it can combine with the p orbitals which are present in the 4p subshell. They will combine. Atomic orbitals with the small difference in the energies will get hybridized. Promotion of electron is not essential prior to hybridization. That means, students, excitation of electron to the higher energy level or to the other orbital in the same orbit, that is not an essential condition before the hybridization. Some cases, excitation of electron will take place before hybridization. Some cases, after the hybridization, excitation of electrons will take place. Not only atomic orbitals with single electrons sometimes orbitals with are completely filled orbitals, you can write it as single electrons will get hybridized. Sometimes filled orbitals and vacant orbitals will also undergo hybridization. Dear students, these are the conditions for hybridization, right? Atomic orbitals present in valence shell of an atom will be hybridized. Atomic orbitals with a small difference in energies will get hybridized. Excitation of electron prior to the hybridization, it is not essential. Not only atomic orbitals with a single electron will get hybridized, sometimes completely filled orbitals and vacant orbitals also will undergo hybridization, right? Now, let us discuss about the salient features of the hybridization. Dear students, next, salient features of hybridization. Salient features of hybridization. Hybrid orbitals are hybrid orbitals are same in number as the atomic orbitals get hybridized. Students, that means if two atomic orbitals are combining, then it will give us two hybrid orbitals. If three atomic orbitals are combining, it will give us three hybrid orbitals. How many atomic orbitals are combining? Same number of hybrid orbitals they will give. Hybrid orbitals are equivalent in shape and energy. Equivalent in shape and energy. Hybrid orbitals form more effective bonding than pure atomic orbitals. Because of greater extent of overlapping, hybrid orbitals will form more effective bonding than the pure atomic orbitals. Hybrid orbitals are oriented in space such that there is maximum distance in between them. That means the shape of molecule depends on hybridization. Students, indirectly the shape of the molecule will depends on the hybridization. Let us continue our discussion with the first type of hybridization, that is sp hybridization. Types of hybridization. Types of hybridization. First type is sp hybridization. In this type of hybridization, students, one s orbital, it is combining with the one p orbital, which gives two equivalent sp hybridized orbitals. It will give us two sp hybridized orbitals which are oriented in the space such that in between them, that is 180 degree angle is present. Students, the hybrid orbitals always indicated with the one big lobe and one small lobe. These two orbitals are sp hybridized orbitals. When two atomic orbitals are combining, of atomic orbitals of small difference in the energy they are combining, then they will give two equivalent hybrid orbitals which has a same shape and energy, right? Sp hybridized orbitals it is giving. So students, in this percentage s character is 50% s 50% p it is present in the hybrid orbitals, 50% percentage S character is 50% here, right? Examples for this type of hybridization is BeCl2, BeF2, beryllium chloride, beryllium fluoride, carbon dioxide, C2H2, NO2 plus, HgCl2, etc. Here, geometry and shape of the molecule is linear. Geometry and shape of the molecule is, shape of the molecules is linear. Angle is 180 degrees. Bond angle is 180 degrees. Students, let us discuss the structure of the BeCl2 now, which has sp2 hybridization. BeCl2, beryllium, atomic number 4, electronic configuration 1s2 2s2 1s2 2s2, ground state electronic configuration, ground state orbital diagram for the beryllium, we can indicate it as 2s as 2 electrons, 2p does not contain any electrons. In the first excited state, this electron present in the 1 electron present in the 2s orbital is jumped into 2p orbital. One electron will jump into the 2p orbital. Right, then 1s orbital, 1 2s orbital is combining with the 1 2p orbital, which gives two equivalent sp hybridized orbitals. Let us continue the orbital diagrams for this. Dear students, in the beryllium, first excited state, 2s as one electron, 2s as one electron, 2p also having one electron, 2p also having one electron. These two orbitals will combine to form two equivalent sp hybridized orbitals. They are oriented in the space such that there is a maximum distance, minimum repulsions, linear in the shape, right? And in the chlorine, atomic number 17, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p5. It requires one more electron to complete the octet, 8 electrons in the outermost shell. Then each p orbital of a chlorine containing unpaired electron or the single electron is overlapping with the sp hybridized orbital of these two are the sp hybrid orbitals of beryllium. SP hybrid orbitals of the beryllium, and these are overlapping with the p orbitals of the each chlorine. Two chlorines are there in the BeCl2, right? So these containing single electrons with the opposite spin, they will combine. They are overlapping now. Friends, hybrid orbitals always forms a sigma bonds. Hybrid orbitals, they will make a effective bonding and they will always forms a sigma bonds. This is a p orbital of a chlorine. This is a p orbital of other chlorine. P orbital of other chlorine. Next type of hybridization is sp2 hybridization. sp2 hybridization. 1s orbital, 2p orbitals will combine px, py will combine, x axis, y axis, total 3 orbitals are combining, it will give us 3 hybrid orbitals. They are oriented in the space such that there is a maximum distance, minimum repulsions, that is with the trigonal planar geometry. When we join these edges, we will get equilateral triangle, trigonal planar geometry, and each angle, these angles are equal, which is equal to 120 degrees. 3 sp2 equivalent orbitals, they are equivalent orbitals, equal in energy and shape, angle is 120, percentage s character is 33.33%, percentage s character is 33.33%. Examples for this type of hybridization is BCl3, BF3, NO3-, C2H4, ethylene, etc. Students, let us discuss about the hybridization in the boron trichloride, BCl3, now. Students, now let us discuss about the hybridization of boron in the BCl3. Boron atomic number 5, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p1, outermost shell it has 3 electrons. Orbital diagram in the ground state, we can write like this. Ground state configuration, orbital diagram, 2s has 2 electrons and 2p has 1 electron. Excited state, this will jump into the 2p orbital. Then first excited state, orbital diagram, 2s has 1 electron, 2p has 2 electrons now. So here 1s orbital and 2p orbitals will combine to give 3 sp2 hybridized orbitals, equivalent orbitals. 1, 2, 3 equivalent hybrid orbitals. Hybrid orbitals always indicated with the one big lobe and one small lobe. The angle between these orbitals are 120, right? In the chlorine case, we are talking about the BCl3, chlorine, atomic number 17, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p5. So outermost shell it has 7 electrons. The chlorine requires one more electron, right? 3 chlorine atoms are there. 3 chlorine atoms are overlapping with the each sp2 hybridized orbitals like this. Hybrid orbitals always forms a sigma bonds. Each chlorine, this is p orbital of each chlorine containing single electrons, and these are having the electrons with the opposite spin, they are overlapping. This is sp2 hybrid orbital, p orbital of chlorine, sp2 hybrid orbital of boron, and p orbital of chlorine, sp2 hybrid orbital of boron, and p orbital of chlorine. Here students, geometry is trigonal planar geometry, because all these atoms along with the central atom, they are present in the plane of the board, same plane they are present. And shape for the BCl3 also same it is. But students, when we take SO2, S double bond O, double bond O, it has one lone pair of electrons. To get the hybridization of the central atom, we need to count the sigma bonds and lone pairs. double bond. In the double bond, 1 sigma 1 pi, 1 sigma 1 pi, 2 sigma bonds 1 lone pair. So hybridization is sp2, but it has 2 bond pairs and 1 lone pair. It is present. Sigma bond pairs are 2, 1 lone pair it is present. Hybridization is sp2 with 2 bond pairs and 1 lone pair. Students, when we are talking about a geometry, we can consider lone pairs also. So trigonal planar, trigonal planar, but shape of the molecule in the case of SO2 is bent shape, bent shape. Now let us discuss about the third type of hybridization, which is sp3 hybridization. Next type of hybridization is sp3 hybridization. sp3 hybridization. Students, in this hybridization, 1s orbital, it is combining with the 3p orbitals, px orbital plus py orbital, x axis, this is y axis now, right? Py orbital plus pz orbital. 1s orbital, it is combining with the 3p orbitals, which gives 4 equivalent sp3 hybridized orbitals. 4 equivalent sp3 hybridized orbitals, which are oriented in the space such that there is a, the geometry of these hybrid orbitals is tetrahedral geometry. Tetrahedral with each angle it is the same, which is 109 degrees 28 minutes. And these are oriented in the space such that the geometry of this orbitals is tetrahedral. Angle, bond angle is 109 degrees 28 minutes. And the percentage S character is, out of the 4 orbitals, only 1 is S. So it is a 25%. Students, let us take some examples for this sp3 hybridization. CH4, C2H6, NH3, SO42-, H2O, etc. Let us take the CH4 molecule now. CH4, carbon atomic number 6, electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Outermost shell, it has 4 electrons. First excited state. 2s has 1 electron. Students, I am not writing ground state configuration. Directly, I am writing first excited state configuration. Then 2p has 3 electrons. This is 2s, 2p has 3 electrons. 1s orbital, 3p orbitals will combine to give 4 sp3 hybrid orbitals. These are oriented in the space as set. The geometry in between them, geometry is tetrahedral geometry, right? 4 hydrogens are there. H, 1 is atomic number, electronic configuration is 1s1. So each sp3 hybrid orbital of carbon is overlapping with the 4, that is 1s orbital of hydrogen. 1s orbital of hydrogen. 1s orbital of hydrogen. Students, here the molecule number of bond pairs, loan pairs, geometry, it is the same all the cases. What is the shape of the molecule? Shape of the molecule, shape here last, right? Molecule CH4, bond pairs, 4 bond pairs, lone pairs 0. Geometry and shape both, it is same. Tetrahedral geometry. If it is ammonia, which is having 3 bond pairs, 1 lone pair, geometry is same for all the cases. So specifically I am writing only shape, geometry it is the same. So that's why shape alone I am writing. Shape and geometry in the case of CH4, that is a tetrahedral. But in the case of ammonia, it is pyramidal. Geometry means we have to consider lone pair of electrons also. Then in the case of ammonia, CH4, geometry is same, that is tetrahedral. But shape of the CH4 is tetrahedral, ammonia is pyramidal. In water molecule, oxygen is having sp3 hybridization with the 2 bond pairs, 2 lone pairs. Shape of the molecule is bent shape. Geometry is tetrahedral, but shape of the molecule is bent shape. Students, this is about the different types of hybridizations. In that, first 3 types we have discussed, sp, sp2, sp3, with the some examples. Thanks for watching.